How to stop bad luck instantly by removing limiting beliefs. Have you ever asked yourself, why do I have such bad luck? Why don't my relationships work out? Why do I keep getting passed over for that promotion? Or why can't I even catch a break? And what can I do to stop living in this cycle of rejection and failure? In this short video, I am going to be sharing you the secret to stopping the bad luck in your life so those cycles stop repeating. My name is Joanna, and I am passionate about helping people who are struggling with stress, depression, or anxiety manage their negative thoughts and emotions. The biggest problem I see when it comes to bad luck is that it's not just a one-off thing. People who are called unlucky are ones that actually have multiple things that keep happening in sequence that show proof that there is something amiss. Something is just not right. You've heard the saying, bad luck comes in threes, right? So there is something that's not quite right that is causing the sequence of events that are deemed as unlucky. Think about it. The most common phrase we hear when things go wrong is, that always happens. They always use me. I always lose. They never choose me. Things always go wrong. And when things don't go our way, we start struggling with thoughts like we're not good enough. Maybe something is wrong with us. Maybe we're just not worthy of this thing, this relationship, or this promotion. Maybe there's something that's inherently wrong within us. And these negative thoughts make us feel so bad. And our perception of the situation at the same time reinforces those negative emotions, and they become a part of our regular thought habits. Since our thoughts determine our experiences, we just attract the same type of situation in over and over. That's the definition of the law of attraction. Like attracts like. So having those negative thoughts a part of our habitual thinking attracts that type of situation on the regular into our lives. So it becomes a recurring sequence. This is why, in order to get out of the sequence of bad luck, you have to get rid of your limiting beliefs. And you may be thinking, what limiting beliefs? I don't have any limiting beliefs. The things I believe are based on science, observation. This is what I see in nature all around me happening in the world, right? But what if I were to tell you that that's not necessarily the case? What if I were to tell you that the evidence that you look for is the evidence you will find? For example, have you or anyone you've known ever gotten a new car and you've never seen that car really around before, or not much, but then suddenly this person or you have this car, suddenly you're seeing this car left and right. You see evidence that it's all over the place. It's all about what you are open to perceive. So that being said, you need to get rid of the limiting beliefs that you have. And you find these limiting beliefs by examining what negative things you believe about the situation you just went through. So let's take the example of relationship issues. Let's say you go through relationship after relationship and none of them ever work out. There's always a breakup in the end. No matter how long you're together, whether it's 1 month or whether it's 5 years, you're still end up breaking up in the end. So I want you to take a look at your relationships and try to determine, what is the reason? What went wrong? Was one person jealous all the time? Was there a lot of insecurity? Was the other person cheating? Was there any specific issues that you're seeing that recur? And what does that say about you? What does that say to you about yourself and about how you view relationships? Are there any negative underlying beliefs, such as people are prone to cheat in relationships, or that people get bored and that you need to keep things spicy in order to keep them, or maybe that it's very hard to keep a relationship? Or let's take the example of money and career. What are the underlying beliefs behind you losing that promotion? Is it because you feel not qualified? Is it because you're losing and everyone else is losing? These negative beliefs are your limiting beliefs. They are limiting your vision for things only within the scope of those beliefs. In order to see things beyond it, you have to be able to have beliefs that are bigger and allow for more. So what we need to do in order to get rid of these limiting beliefs is to replace them. And I know it sounds daunting and hard because they are in our subconscious. So it's from our childhood, passed on from family and friends when we were growing up. It's our brain trying to make sense of the world that we were observing when we were little. But as we grew up, those particular beliefs that the brain made sense of didn't apply anymore and are actually hurting us. This is a time to let go of those old beliefs that are no longer accurate to the world around us, that are actually hurting us because they're limiting us to see only the bad, the negative. We want to replace them with things that are positive. So you get to choose what beliefs you want to replace them with. Yes, you do. You have that choice. And I know it may sound ridiculous. You may be thinking, this is not like going to the store and walking down the aisle and picking, you know, Fruit Loops over Cocoa Puffs. It's kind of a bigger thing. You know, you're trying to supplant something in the subconscious. I'm not making light of it, but there is a way to do this. So once you choose your positive beliefs that you want to replace them with, what you want to do is reinforce them. And you reinforce them by making affirmations that match those beliefs. So you reaffirm them to yourself multiple times a day, at least once or twice a day. Just repeat those affirmations for 21 to 30 days just to get those thinking habits in order in your head. Because after about 21 days, you kind of form a habit that those thoughts will come naturally to you first above those old ones that you had in the past. So you want to reaffirm those daily, and on top of that, to make things quicker, to make things easier, is you want to look for evidence of those beliefs. And you may be thinking, how am I supposed to see the evidence of the positive belief when all this time I've been seeing evidence of the negative belief reflected in my life, right? Bad luck keeps happening to me. Those relationships never work out. I have such bad luck in relationships. Or I just can never catch a break with my job. I can never find a good paying job. I always have to keep working so many hours and never making enough money to make me happy. So what I mean by looking for evidence is not necessarily in your own life. I want you to look around. I want you to find evidence in the outside world of that new belief. So let's use the example of a limiting belief regarding work. So let's say you believe that you have to work a lot of hours and put a lot of effort in to be able to receive a certain amount of money. And let's say you want to replace that with a positive belief that you get paid for the value you provide, not the time and effort you put in. So you reaffirm that, you repeat to yourself, I get paid for the value I provide, not for the amount of time and effort I put into the work. And you say that affirmation to yourself every day, multiple times a day if possible, until it becomes a very natural way of thinking for you. And you look for people around who show evidence of that. Look around you. Are there people who don't have to work 50, 60 hour weeks, who don't have to put even a lot of effort into their work but still get paid a lot? Yes, there are. So if it's possible for them, it's also possible for you. So when you see proof of this new belief, your mind says, yeah, this is true. So keep reinforcing it until it becomes a part of you. And when it becomes a part of you, that bad luck, the recurring sequence of things that keeps happening over and over will no longer be a thing. Just imagine having broken that sequence of bad luck, that the next relationship you get into, there is no insecurity, there is no fear of them cheating, because your belief says that you only attract people who are faithful and people who truly love you for who you are. Or the next time there's a promotion, you are chosen for it because your belief system says that people around you see your value. So comment down below, let me know, what new belief are you affirming? Or maybe what limiting belief you need to get rid of? If you like this video, found it helpful, or just entertaining, please hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to this channel, hit that subscribe button and that bell notification icon so that you can be notified every time I upload a new video, because I am dedicating to help you gain mastery over your mind and emotions. I'll see you next time. Bye.